What's up, everybody? Simon here. In this video, I wanted to go ahead and go over the stock market crash that is potentially happening very soon. If you have money in the stock market, if you're about to put money in the stock market, be aware it is very likely that we are going to be headed past the correction into a potential crash that's going to be catastrophic for your finances as well as the economy in general. Before I get into this video, I always remind you guys, hit the like button for me and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. I appreciate it. So let's get into this video and see why we are headed towards an inevitable stock market crash. As you may know, the stock market has been going up like crazy. In fact, it's up 36%.
70 record closing highs so far for the Dow.
Blasting through a ceiling.
In a record-setting IPO.
Investors who have been riding the wave.
When the stock market is booming, we're made to believe the economy is booming. And in America, the stock market has been mostly booming for almost 40 years.
What the market is telling us is that we are on the road to prosperity.
In the skyrocketing stock market, and that benefits everyone.
The stock market has gained almost $3 trillion in value since the election.
It has been a wild ride. As someone that has stocks as well, I've been very happy with the outcome of the stocks that I've invested in. However, in the back of my mind, I am also worried that we might be headed towards one of the biggest crashes we've seen since maybe 1987 or potentially 2008, where the stock markets just tumbled. The crazy thing is, with the stocks going up, so have cryptocurrency prices. We did have a little bit correction of cryptocurrencies where Bitcoin has dipped below $30,000 and now it's all of a sudden back up to $45,000. Dogecoin, the same thing, dipped to about 15 cents, up past 30 cents. But typically, cryptocurrency has been up when the stock market has been down. And the stock market has not seen a correctional period like the cryptocurrency market has, because crypto did go down, the stocks just keep going up and up. So the stock market had a great trip this year. All in all, there were a few little dips, not more than 5%, but 2021 has been great for the stock market. This is caused by several factors. One, potentially inflation. There is so much money being printed and out there that people are investing in the stocks, they're buying up the goods, and companies are able to show great returns. Additionally, people were saving their money in 2020, and unless your product was one of the cleaning supplies or toilet paper or paper towels, you could have had an off year in 2020. However, in 2021, once people were able to get out of the house, they literally started spending like crazy, which has shown the likes of a holiday event when it came down to these companies where all of a sudden there's an influx in spending during the holidays. Well, this happened post-pandemic, so the influx of all the spending and companies resuming business has kept the stock market at a higher than usual trend. Now, if you own stocks, you need to know, and you probably do already, that you should always diversify. Never invest into one stock unless it's a bulletproof stock such as Amazon or Google or any of these companies like Apple. So if it's a blue chip or a stock that you feel confident in, always diversify your portfolio. And a good example of that is sometimes stock markets can hit a segment in the market, and that causes potentially certain stocks to tumble.
Let's talk about the speed with which we are watching this market deteriorate.
We're red everywhere, essentially, down by 4-5%.
We're down over 16%.
Dow, at the same time, has fallen about 18%.
But if you diversify your portfolios and you, say, invest in pharmaceuticals, steel, oil, tech, etc., one of the segments may be hit, but the other segments may cover your losses or give you gains that you would not realize are possible. One thing to note is every stock has always recovered from a downturn. So even if you look during the stock market crashes that we've seen in 2008 and other years, stocks have always rebounded to higher highs. And in fact, S&P has a natural progression to gain year over year, earning you a very good residual on your investment. So with that being said, you have to have emergency funds. Don't invest everything in the stock market. Keep some emergency funds around. And I've made videos on my channel in regards to that, having funds to carry you over during hard times. And we may be on the cusp of a financially unstable time, given the fact that the moratoriums are pretty much expired. The stock market has not seen a big dip and money is just all over the place. The unemployment rates are not as good as they hoped for. So there's a lot of things happening in the country that could potentially burst this bubble of inflated stock prices. One crazy fact is the S&P 500 has grown over 60% in the last 14 months. That is the highest growth it saw in the last 50 years. Now, according to Harry Dent, who's considered to be the contrarian of contrarians, the stock market crash will happen in the next 3 months. He's expecting it to happen in September.
August, September, October are the classic months that it happens.
He said that this is going to be the biggest crash of our lifetime.
That yes, the demographic trends here and in East Asia and in Europe, all the developed countries, continue to get worse, especially in the next 2 to 3 years. So yeah, no easy recovery from this.
Which is gonna be massive if it comes true. It could be a crash on the scale of the Great Depression. Now, Harry Dent sounds like a character out of Batman.
When the chips are down, these civilized people, they'll eat each other.
So is he credible? You betcha. So he thinks the worst year of the stock market will be in 2022 and 2023 because of all the residual or the ripple effects of the crash. So it looks like stocks are not going to rebound, according to Harry, until maybe 2024 to 2025. And the reason he's saying is, even though we look like we're having a great economy and it looks bullish for the long term, there are factors being played into why the stocks are so high, and some of those I addressed earlier. Yet there are unknown questions and events that have not happened that will potentially drag all of this down. He is basically saying there'll be one crash that will convince investors things are not as robust as we like to think they are. And potentially, in my opinion, that could be the moratorium freezes that are going to be let go shortly, the paybacks of all those loan deferments, and possibly just the hype of the stock market being higher than what it should be at. And it's not that the stock market is in, say, a big problematic situation. It's the fact that it's overinflated. It's not normal, according to Harry Dent. So he is not worried about the fact that if stock market investing is a good thing or bad thing. He just feels like the stock market is at a peak. And when you are at a peak, we've learned from past experiences, you have to come back down. And that's why I mentioned the corrections earlier. We've never had a correction more than 5%. However, the S&P 500 is over 60% positive just from 14 months ago without a single correction. With that being said, we're due for a massive correction. I also made a video in the past that the central banks are in trouble because of cryptocurrency. There's over $1 trillion circulating out there in cryptocurrency that's not in the banking system.
A lot of people are steering away, keeping their money in the bank account and rolling it over into cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, now Dogecoin, and a bunch others out there.
Now, if it's not in the banking system, that means that circulating supply of money is without potential investment into stock markets, etc. Lots of banks do not invest in cryptocurrencies or any alternatives such as that. So that money is out. And the stock market, fortunately, has been on a positive money supply where a lot of money is also in the stock market in terms of the total value of assets in the stock market. Now, with more people pulling that money out and investing it into cryptocurrency for better returns, the stock market investments are going to start getting depleted. The banking investments are going to start getting a little bit depleted. The banks will need to start competing for your money. Once the banks start competing for your money, or there's a shortage of money with the banks, this potentially will be a problem with the stock market as there'll be less investment. So as we've been saying that the stock market has constantly been rebounding past COVID, they're actually not allowing the stock market to properly rebalance and show its natural value of pricing. This is going to happen. That's the big correction that everyone is worried about. And it's stated that over 20% of large public companies are not able to keep up with their debt because they're large public companies. They employ the most amount of people. If they employ the most amount of people and they're only getting by because of the stock prices and their stocks being higher, so they keep having more liquidity to, say, put out the fire but not recover from debt, this is becoming a major problem. And the governments are just bailing people out. So who does that help? Is basically nobody. By printing more money, you're creating an inflation, which is an unrealistic gain. That gain becomes chipped away with debt that's going to happen when companies or corporations are not managed properly. They're not going to eventually be able to pay off those debts or those loans or anything in between, causing a massive crash. Now, I also did a video that mentioned real estate was slowing down. And yes, it is technically slowing down in certain key areas.
Recently, the housing market went significantly lower in terms of availabilities. There are more houses on the market, so the supply is higher. The demand has decreased a bit, even though we have a very low interest rate. I'm just stunned.
If the real estate also starts slowing down, and that's before the moratorium ends and before the influx of supply in housing, we are gonna also see a potential ripple effect into the stock market. A lot of people have been buying real estate because they've been doing great with their stock options, their stock market prices, etc. But if it slows down, we get more supply from moratorium foreclosures, and all of a sudden there's a lot of supply in the real estate market, guess what? The stock market is gonna also take a hit. Eventually, the confidence in the buying processes, the people that are buying, is gonna dwindle. They're gonna start pulling money out, and people are gonna start getting worried, not putting more money back into the stock market. So everything is overvalued. The home market was overvalued. The stock market is overvalued. Cryptocurrency is definitely potentially overvalued, depending on which coins. And we saw corrections with cryptocurrency, especially alternative coins, where they have dipped immense amounts. But things being overvalued does not necessarily mean that is gonna be the way it will continue to trend. In fact, corrections are bound to happen. We have not seen that in the stock market, and that's why a lot of people are expecting a correction to happen, or in fact, a major crash. So the question is, should you sell your stocks? Well, obviously check with your financial advisors. However, if we start seeing a downward trend in the S&P, if we start seeing an issue with real estate going even further, I think it would be a great time to sell your stocks, potentially to be able to buy them at a lower rate somewhere down the line. It only takes one little snowflake to cause an avalanche, and we are in the cusp of a potential avalanche with such overinflated prices in so many different sectors, from luxury goods to homes to stocks to real estate, etc. It's gonna happen potentially. Now, if you start seeing it happen, it may be a good time to get rid of the stock, take your profits, wait for the market to turn around, which has not been turned around for what, 13, 14 years now, and really see what we could do to make even more money on the downturn. So that is my video on the stock market, why I believe it will crash. My biggest reason is, again, real estate is way inflated. And at the same time, there's this elephant in the room with the moratoriums ending and people potentially not being able to pay their mortgages. There's also many individuals not paying rent, tying up the legal system with all these rents that are due back when they move out. Landlords cannot evict their tenants at this time, but they will be able to shortly. And the real estate market may actually lead that next crash that may happen in specific areas or even throughout the country. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment below if you have any feedback to a potential stock market crash. We're due. What do you guys think? Is it going to happen? And if you think it will happen or it won't, comment below and I'll respond. As always, I appreciate you watching. Thank you, and I'll catch you guys here in the next video.